In this video, I describe what is called Cornell method of note-taking. Your note sheet in a Cornell method would look like this. So, when your client is giving you information or something that is being said that you regard as important, you make a note of it. Your note section will carry an outline of all that is being said, and the margins are to be used for making what I call a super note that would be a key event. The way I see it, you should be able to summarize the outcome of the meeting, including further discussion points at the bottom. In order for it to serve as a note for drafting a plan or a court motion, you would perhaps need to use the same note sheet but make a detailed note about dates and events. Your cue column should be the list of actions or specific actionables, and what is to be done could then fall in your summary point. This is only one method of note-taking. You have to appreciate that there is no right or wrong method of note-taking. It all depends on how much you write and how much you trust your memory. Of course, the amount of writing that you are going to do will depend on what you regard as important. No two people attending the same client conference are likely to have identical notes. However, from experience, one can judge if any important point that must be noted in the notes had been missed by a junior lawyer. Some of the most common abbreviations that can be used while taking notes are available to you in the supplement section of this video.